Hello, my loves. It's your girl, Blue Phoenix, and we're back with another message today. I do hope that this message finds you well and in good health. All right, feeling great and fantastical. And if you're not, it's my intentions that you will be by the end of this reading, okay? So come on in, collective. Today, we did have a request for a Scorpio reading. So if you are a Scorpio, sun, moon, rising, or have it anywhere highly aspected in your chart, this reading could resonate for you. Or if you know a Scorpio, stick around. There may be a message for you as well. All right? All right, Holy Spirit. So let's see what's going on in Scorpio land. Okay, so your number today is 11. All right, so we got justice. A Libra could be significant. All right, we have alignment as well is what I'm hearing. All right, so Holy Spirit, help me tap in with the Scorpio collective and see what's going on. We have crystal. All right, have faith and hope because there is something positive and new on the horizon that you can't yet see. All right, I just did a Pisces reading and this came up in their reading too, so a Pisces could be significant for you. Okay, all right, or you can have it in your birth chart somewhere. All right, behind that we have Teresa. It says, time out. You've been so busy taking care of everyone else's needs, but now it's time to stop and take care of yourself. Right up under that, you have Athena with, it is safe to be powerful. You know how to be loving in a way that is that benefits others as well as yourself. All right? Okay. All right, Holy Spirit. Any other messages from Scorpios, angels, ancestors, past over loved ones? All right, we got one more. All right, so we have Caressa. It says, you are at the end of a cycle in your life. Call upon your angels to comfort you and guide you to your next steps. Happiness awaits you now. All right, so there's something about not waiting to be happy and to be happy in this very present moment because something new and positive is on the horizon for you. As I said, the number 11, justice, something is coming into alignment for you, Scorpio. So let's see what this thing is. On the bottom of the deck, you have Serafina. Any of these names could be significant. Crystal, Teresa, Athena, Caressa, and Serafina, okay? I am the angel of families, a happy change or addition is coming to your family. All right. All right. So let's see. I think I want to do this deck. All right, Holy Spirit. So what is this that's coming in for Scorpio? All right. Some sort of surprise. Okay. I always think of a surprise when I see that damn fish popping up out that cup in the page. And then something is happening quickly too. Quicker than you may expect. What is this something positive and new that they can't see, Holy Spirit? For one thing, make sure you are taking time for yourself to love on yourself. All right, so you're not pouring from an empty cup, okay? There's also something here about you standing in your power. All right, and being proud, okay? Being proud of who you are. I'm hearing also what you've done. I don't know what you did, but I don't know. Be proud of it, okay? All right, give me a second. A cat could be significant, okay? I don't know. Let's see if a cat is in this spirit animal book that I got. Hold on, cat. Page 94. All right, that year could be significant. All right, so the cat says, independent and self-assured, intuitive and insightful, agile and astute. Okay, all right, interesting. It says, cat's teaching is often one of presence, so pay attention to subtle cues and feelings. Move sensuously, Perceive deeply and awaken your inner feline. Once you do, you'll never take any cat for granted. Interesting. All right, so something about independence here as well could be significant for you. All right. All right, so what's on the horizon for us, Scorpio? Some sort of choice, some sort of decision, because I did just see the Seven of Cups as well. So there could be some sort of decision or choice you're making here in the very near future, okay? Very near future for Scorpio. Queen of Cups, you. All right, Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer energy. It's something about a new wardrobe here as well for you. All right, you got another queen, but this is way too many cards. Hold on. And the Two of Swords is still there on that bottom of the deck. Okay. Y'all, 222? What the freak? This could be a same-sex relationship. This don't have to be romantic. Like, this could be a friend or something. But you got the Lovers here and the Two of Cups, y'all, with the Two of Swords. You literally have the Queen of Cups, the Queen of Wands, the Two of Cups, the Two of Pentacles, the Lovers, and the Two of Swords on the bottom of the deck. 222 could be significant for you. Let me write that down. I don't know. Y'all might want to go check out that Pisces reading. They had 333. And they were calling in some sort of support in their life, too. So, I don't know. Maybe a Pisces will be helping you, or you'll be helping a Pisces. And yeah, yeah. All right. But right now, we have Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer. Leo, Aries, Sagittarius energy, okay? But there's some sort of connection coming in here for you, Scorpio. For some reason, though, you're unsure about this connection. This is a soulmate or something. This is like a soulmate, or for some of y'all, this could even be a twin flame, okay? With the Lovers here and the Two of Cups. That's like shit. Okay, somebody is like, you are so used to being the person that has to do everything, not necessarily everything, but it's giving me very much that you do, right? You do. There is a message here to be. Okay, so stop, like, lay off of being a human doing and be more of a human being. You get what I'm saying? Like, it's something about chill out for a second. I don't know. You're used to being in some sort of like leader, okay? Whether this is in the home, the work, and your friendships, I don't know. I don't know if you always have to take the wheel, you know what I'm saying? But I'm hearing like, let Jesus take it, okay? Or whoever you work with, okay? Let them take it, your spirit team. Because something's here, but you may have so much going on that I don't know. You got to allow this to come in. Somebody's bringing in resources for you as well. Like, somebody's coming in to be a benefit in your life instead of a deduction, is what I heard. I don't know what that's about, but okay. All right, a Gemini could be significant here. It's also something here about communication as well, okay? This is love. I mean, it don't have to be romantic, but this is somebody who you are going to love or who you do love, okay? All right, tell me more, Spirit. Can you give me one for the Queen of Cups, please? The Star and the Six of Swords. This is healing. This is going to be a healing connection. This is somebody's coming in and they're bringing healing. This is a very happy change. It's something about diving deep, though. Okay, Oceana is right up under that. And then Vanessa. So Vanessa says, to make your decision, ask yourself, which way brings me closer to my divine purpose? Which way takes me away from it? All right, with this Two of Swords and Two of Pentacles and shit like that, like making this, even the six, the Lovers, is a card of choice. Okay, so you can have many people in your atmosphere, or your environment, or your energy, but it's something about picking the right person. Okay, like picking the right person out the crowd. You've been dealt a heavy hand with people in the past, though. Like being taken advantage of. And it's giving me very much like I heard post and ghost. Okay, I don't know what that's about, but yeah. All right, tell me about this Queen of Wands, please. That's too many. Let's look, though. Give me one for the Queen of Wands. This could be a masculine person in their feminine energy, or a feminine in their masculine energy, okay? Give me one for the Queen of Wands, please, for Scorpio. This positive thing on the horizon. There's definitely a message here, though, tonight. Look, even the moon, like you. Give me a second. Tell me about the Queen of Wands, please. Why is the Queen of Wands here? Is this Scorpio's energy or this outside of them? This is your energy, the Nine of Pentacles. This is you. Interesting. All right, there's definitely something here about it's giving me very much the lower chakras. Okay, it's giving me root, sacral, and solar plexus chakras. Okay, your spirit team could be working with you to heal those chakras within you, to clear those chakras out. Okay, interesting. Because there's something here about a confidence, a knowing, right? Interesting. And then it says self-assured on it, and that's the Nine of Pentacles. The Nine of Pentacles is all about, you know what I'm saying? Like, she did this independently, right? She was sure of herself. She was confident that she could achieve this goal, and she did, all by her damn self. Okay, I don't know why it's not getting clear. There we go. You're used to doing something independently, but there's some sort of help coming in. But it's only if you are open to receive it. See, you used to this. You're used to this. Somebody is used to doing things by themselves, or having to do things on your own, or something like that. You could be tired of that shit. Okay. I don't know. It's something about like, damn, shit. But okay, y'all, the Five of Swords with the Knight of Cups. Tell me about the Two of Cups, Holy Spirit. Why is the Two of Cups here for Scorpio, for what's coming in for them? Who is this? What is this? The King of Pentacles, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus could be significant. Nine of Swords. Seven of Pentacles. Like I said, you could be ready for someone to come in, honestly. Some sort of help, a friend, a lover, a family member, whatever. It's giving me, though, somebody helping you take a time out. Real talk. What are we worried about here? If something's gonna work out, what's the Nine of Swords for? Somebody could be like scared of starting over or something here. Give me a second. For some of you all, you could already know this person or be in a relationship, a friendship with someone, but you could be kind of scared or second guessing yourself about asking someone for help or even accepting help from someone here. Your spirit team is working with you though to give you a new perspective about this. Give me the Two of Pentacles, please. What's that here for? Damn. King of Cups. That's a pair, y'all. The King and the Queen of Cups. This is a balanced pair, but for whatever reason, somebody is second guessing this, though. Give me one more for the Two of Pentacles. Yo, this is a soulmate, bro. Real talk, this is the Ten of Pentacles. It came in reverse, but it's the Ten of Pentacles. Somebody could not feel confident about something here. Somebody could feel like, this could be you or this person, one of y'all. Somebody feels like they're not, it's something about instability. All right, somebody's emotions could even be unstable right now, okay? Damn. Oh my God. Somebody could be having like family issues or some shit, yo. This could be you or this could be this person. Somebody's not happy though. Shit. You could be helping this person. And they could be feeling like resistant to allowing you to help them, or vice versa. Put it where it goes, Scorpio, okay? All right. You got the Ten of Cups in reverse, Nine of Cups in reverse, Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Somebody could even be trying to make a situation work that they know is over. Like, it's no repair to something. Okay. The Two of Swords is back, y'all. Like, somebody could literally... Wow, this could go so many ways, y'all, right? This could be... Because you got the Two of Cups right here, the Two of Swords, right? Like, somebody could have two people. Remember something? You or somebody else could have two people that are available, right? Like, we could, they're single, or either they are willing to welcome in a new friend or something like that. But it's like somebody is in the middle. Like, they don't know if they want this Two of Cups or the Lovers. Wow. Somebody's going back and forth here. And it looks like, whether this is you or them, somebody is like, well, shit, if I'm just independent, then I could do it on my own. Right? I don't know. It's something about compromise here that somebody may not be ready to do. Some sort of compromise or something. Somebody's not ready to let something go, though. Like, oh my God. This person is worried. Somebody is worried about allowing someone new to come in or trying to repair something that's totally fucking broken, bro. This is interesting. Okay, tell me about the Lovers. What's the Lovers? Somebody wants something to be more stable in their life, though, I feel like. Somebody's looking for stability. okay? Temperance. Listen, I don't know if this is you that's having a hard decision about staying in something that they're already in or going towards a new offer that God is presenting to you, or if this is somebody else, but somebody, listen, this new thing looks exciting. It looks aligned. Okay, it looks harmonious. Okay, literally, you got harmony on temperance and harmony in the lovers, right? Tell me about the lovers, please. Somebody is so used to shit not working out in their favor, though. Like, I feel like somebody is scared to let something go and try somewhere else, or welcome in a new friend or a new lover or whatever. Somebody is so used to something being fleeting. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's Scorpio. That is kind of your energy. It's impermanence, right? So it's like Scorpios know they ain't nothing fucking forever. You understand what I'm telling you? But I don't know if this is you or somebody else, but somebody needs to let this shit go. Because this is ill. All these reversals, why would you stay in this? Because somebody's scared to move forward. But in this right here, you're exhausted. Somebody's exhausted in this. This is a lot. What? Look, it's over. Look, and then I didn't even mean to turn it upside down. Shit. But somebody could be feeling incomplete. It's because you haven't met your match yet. Or they haven't. Somebody, listen. No judgment here for me, right? Somebody is about to have a new offer come in, or this could already be going on. Put yourself in the timeline where you go. But somebody got a new offer coming in. In order for this new offer to work out, this old shit gotta go. And you can't, whoever this is, they can't keep dividing their time up into all these different places. This shit is energetically draining. Okay, this family dispute, this whatever this is, unhappy. Look at these words, y'all. Look at them if they'll get straight. This is not what's up. You see that? Disappointment, separation, disputes. Jeez. Disappointments and shit. I'm gonna turn that back up because it wasn't supposed to be. All these tens, y'all. Something's over. Something's over here. But that's probably why I, you know what I'm saying, intuitively turned it upside down, because somebody ain't closed this damn cycle out yet. Tell me about the lovers, please. The Empress. Somebody gotta open up so they can receive this actual alignment. This aligned relationship. This, whoever this is, they know it. So why are they holding on to this right here, Holy Spirit? They've already emotionally detached. Somebody is not in whatever this is right here. Okay. Somebody is not. They wasting time. I'm not gonna say that. Shh, be quiet, boo. Everybody learn their lesson on their own time. Look. It's too many, though. But you got the Six of Swords, Five of Wands, the Sun, the Knight of Pentacles, and the Three of Pentacles. Somebody's spirit team is literally bringing them in something to help them resolve some sort of like instability, conflict, internal, whatever it is. There is healing here to be had, honestly. This is working together. This is looking out for each other. This is happiness. This is expansion. This is joy right here. It might not happen overnight, but this is a strong, this has the potential to have a strong foundation. Somebody's fighting it, though. I don't know. Oh, Lord. Whatever is going on, something's almost done. Yo. Holy Spirit. Anything else for the lovers? Queen of Swords. Don't overthink something, though. Like, don't overthink it. Give me some advice, Holy Spirit. Look, Merlina, right there. You are confused and indecisive because you don't have enough information. Do research or seek expert advice before making a decision. For somebody here, somebody could even be going through a divorce, okay? Or be considering a divorce. Any other advice? Archangel Uriel, your emotions are healing, okay? Which enables you to open to greater love. I will help you release anger and unforgiveness from your heart and mind. And then on the bottom of the deck, you got Grace and Antoinette. To help this situation, see the other person's point of view with compassion. All right, I'm going to leave it there. I hope that you enjoyed your reading. Let me know your thoughts down below. All right, I love you so much, and I'll talk to y'all later. Bye, my loves.